So hello everyone, welcome to my talk. My name is Müge Kural. I am from Istanbul, Turkey, from Iteration Company. And today I'm going to talk about complex event processing of an electric car and the car, the prototype of a dashboard, car dashboard which runs with this system and which is implemented with Qt. And I plan to talk in two parts. Firstly, I will try to explain what is complex event processing, and next I will tell how did we integrate the system into an electric car, and how did we use Qt. And so first, let me introduce ourselves a little bit. We are Iteration, is a software company which has experiences on software solutions, mostly based on open source tools and middleware platforms. And we have also some technologies, some experiences on mobile and embedded technologies. And today I'm going to talk about one of our embedded solutions. And most of our solutions are based on Java and service-oriented architecture. We have 40 and more staffs, and we are also an Eclipse member. And we have some contributions, some of the Eclipse projects. And me, I'm Müge Kural, I am a software developer. I graduated from Koç University, Istanbul, with a bachelor's degree of science in computer engineering. And I'm working with Iteration more than 1 year. And this is my current project, which I'm working on my company, the electric car project, embedded project. And so let me start. So what is complex event processing? Complex event processing is a method of tracking and analyzing of streams of information and the things that happen inside these streams, which is called events. For example, in this arrangement, you see that we have different data sources, and they can be different devices or sensors, and all of them are producing different kinds of data, and they are transporting their data in different protocols. And in order to collect this data, you have adapters, data adapters, in some kind of gateway. And in this gateway, we collect the source, we collect the data of the sources and with the different protocols, and we identify the data that we retrieved from different sources. And then after we identify the data, we put each of the events inside this data to the different streams. We put them to our system, and all of these events put to the different event streams. And then these event streams joins to a rule engine, a processor, which we load some rule sets inside this processor. And according to these rule sets, these plans, the streams and the events are executed. And by this way, you drive a conclusion from the complex number of events and data. And this processor actually produces an action for all the kind of data from different sources. And how did we integrate this system into an electric car? As all you can guess, in this case, we have data sources are the parts inside our embedded car, the parts inside the car, and there can be the motor of the car, they can be the batteries of an electric car, or the different temperature parts of the car. And the CAN bus protocol are used in the electric car in order to transportation of car. And we have a device which is called CANberry, and I will talk in later in this. And with this device, we communicate with the CAN protocol of the car, and we retrieve the car information to our adapters. And in these adapters, we identify the data that we take from car, and then we again separated them from each as an different events, and then we put these events to the different streams. And then again, we send them to our rule engine, and if there's any rule sets are loaded in this engine, the complex events are processed here, and the engine actually produces an action. And by this way, we handle the real-time car information, and we do whatever we want with this real-time car information. And actually, here in our case, all of our adapters and rule engine are hosted in our gateway. And you can think some kind of simple plan that, for example, in the first stream, we have the we are gaining the speed of vehicle, speed of the electric car. And in the third stream, for example, you have the battery, state of battery. And you have some kind of plan that if the value of the speed of charge exceeds, for example, 100 kilometers over hour, and at the same time, if your battery, if your state of charge is less than 10%, you can create an action and you can tell the driver that you should slow down. And you can, by this way, inform the driver and make some actions with this real-time information of car. Let me do it. And here our system, and actually you see our hardware stack here. At the bottom we have Raspberry Pi 3, and at top of it we have a dual Canberra that I mentioned in the previous slide. With this Canberra board, we communicate with the CAN protocol of the car. And at in front of them, we have a touch screen, as you see here, and this is the dashboard of our dashboard, simple dashboard, which is implemented with Qt. And our software stack is at the bottom. We have hardware, as in Raspberry, and we have JC Lite Linux operating system. It has no windowing system, and at the top of them we have a gateway. We use the Eclipse Cura gateway, which is implemented on Java. And as I said before, all of our adapters and engine hosted in this Cura gateway. And besides of that, we have Qt for our dashboard and for the displaying of real-time information of car. And since we use this version of Qt and we purified our operating system from windowing system, these can work parallelly without no problem. And so that was our system. That was the usual simple event processing system. We retrieved the information of car and we took them to the adapter and then we put them to the different streams. And then we sent them to the processing to be processed them into the engine. And that was the simple case of event processing. But then we thought that we can also use cloud. And while we are sending our information, our car information to the engine, we can also send them to cloud, but by MQTT protocol, which all you know. And by this way, at the same time, if engine produces any action for the rule sets for the car information, the action will also be published to the cloud. And by this way, you will be able to hold all of your real-time car information in the cloud. And since your car information will be on cloud, that means that it will be everywhere, so you can reach them from everywhere. For example, in our case, this is our dashboard, Qt dashboard, and we reach the information, real-time car information from cloud by subscribing to the related channels. And in this dashboard, for example, we subscribe to the speed of vehicle and state of charge channels and some other ampere meter channels. And we are displaying the real-time car information to the user by cloud. They are coming through cloud platform and we display them to the user. And you can also retrieve this information not only from dashboard, but from another platform. And in our case, we have a dashboard for the user. And okay. So I think I have a problem. Okay, and I'm a little fast. Now I want to show you a demo that we had a test drive in our campus. And what is happening? So what do? Okay. I don't know what's the problem. So should I do anything for, okay? Okay. And now I want to show you a demo. We had a test drive in our campus. And here it's a real car, and we are driving our car. And we have two cameras. One of them shows the way, and one of them shows our dashboard. And this is the real-time information of car. And again, we show this information because our car data published to the local MQTT server, and then we subscribe and take them through our cloud server by subscribing to the cloud server, and we show it to the driver. And also in the next part, it's a little shift. In the next part, we show the state of charge to the user, and we also show the ampere meter of the batteries to the user. And we also try to make some little animations, and even the part shifts to the left, it still shows the information to the user. And we have different tabs here, as you can see, and each of them includes different type of data of car. And in this dashboard, we used QML as a language, and we have different pages, page views, and we also try to use, for the MQTT connection, we use the C++ programming basement of the Qt, but we used PAHO libraries here. And by this way, we show the user, we show the driver the real-time information. And in this case, actually, we do not have any plan sets that is loaded in our rule engine, because we are trying to generate some meaningful rule sets for electric car. But if engine would produce any action, it will be also be published to the cloud, and we would be able to show them to the driver here. And actually, it's a little bit blur, but we show here the cell voltage of car to the driver. And yeah. And that's all. So actually, these are the tabs that we did with Qt in our dashboard. I showed you the main page, and also we have a tab for charging statement of our electric car. And again, all of these information are coming through us with cloud system. And also in the left part, we have some other information about car. And we are trying to manage and display some kind of analytics of car to the driver. And so what can be done next? Since we are publishing our real-time car information to cloud, by the way, as I said before, we are using the Eclipse Cura gateway, and in this gateway, we have such a feature that we do not have to publish the information of car as soon as possible. We can also store the data in our gateway. And why this is important, for example, you do not have an internet connection in your car while you are driving, but after a one time, you had an internet connection, and during all of your driving, you will store your data. And after you had an internet connection, maybe this stored data can send to the some programs which maybe do some analytics for your driving or for other helpful information. It can be sent to the some kind of programs. And also another thing that can be done. The plan management, which loads to the rule engine, can be done through Qt interface. For example, we can have some kind of tab and another part on our dashboard, which makes the driver, which driver can generate and load some plans to this engine, which is running beyond the car. And also, the number of rule engines can increase, and the plans can be changed, and you can switch between these plans, and the actions of these engines can be also sent to another engine as an input, and you can also increase the rule engine. And since you will publish your information to cloud, you can reach them to buy them. You can reach them from another cars, and since all of the car information will be on cloud, they can send their information through each other, and they can be a way for car-to-car communication, maybe, we think. And in the system, since you will feed the engine and management of car from cloud, and you will publish, you will subscribe them, and you will publish the results to the cloud, you can change the data sources as an input to the engine. For example, other sources can be the inputs for your adapters and engines. For example, it doesn't have to be a part of the car, but they can be some external sources. For example, some meteorological data or some road conditions can be sent to your device, sent to your car, and they can again can be executed in from your car. And in this state, when after the execution, the dashboard can inform and warns the driver for some specific actions. Should I do something or should I do anything according to that plan? And again, according to your answer, you can make some actions for yourself. For example, you can limit your speed, or if you have a way in the next which is dark, you can open your lights and etc. I mean, by this way, you can be aware of your environment, and you can make your car more maybe smarter and more aware of from its environment. And also, the plan management can be done remotely, because you will open your event management, your engine, to the remote services, and by this way, you will be able to manage your car, your plans, at least, from remote services. And also, you don't have to be sent the plans to your engine, but for example, you also send, for example, from a center, you can send all of the cars on some specific base. You can send all the information, for example, to the cars that on this specific street send the information to the cars and tell them there is a problem in the next corner, or, for example, etc. And briefly, I want to say that by this way, you will open your car to the remote, and you will be able to make your car more more smart and more action. I mean, by this way, your car will be able to take actions by its own, and that can be important thing in the next we think. And actually, I talked a little bit fast, so that's all. Actually, thanks for listening to me. And if you have any questions, I will answer. No? Ah, sorry. No, it's just a prototype. And we also use the open source version of Qt here, actually. It's just prototype for now. But it works on real car. Okay. So thank you. Ah, sorry. What's the delay? Sorry?
What's the delay between the event
Okay. Actually, we didn't notice any delay. I mean, that means a person cannot notify the delay. So I think we are. It's. In
so mm-hmm. if I'd want to support architectures like car-to-car communication over through the cloud, mm-hmm. then it would be interesting how much time I can get status from one car to the other.
Actually, in this case, we are using local servers, so maybe 1 second delay or less. But if we open them to the remote cloud server, maybe the delay can increase. But for now, it's less than 1 second, and we are processing the data, which is produced less than 5 milliseconds, and actually it goes well for now, and there is no delay.
Thank you.
Thank you.